Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Let's talk a little bit about the ABA, if we could. Mr. Van Dyke, you ran for Montana Supreme Court in 2014. Is that correct?
I did.
And people made contributions and supported you and supported your opponents. Is that correct?
They did, Senator.
Marsha Davenport, Montana attorney, donated to your opponent in the 2014 Montana Supreme Court election. Do you know who Marsha Davenport is?
She's the one who interviewed me for the ABA, Senator.
Ah, so she is the one who actually oversaw this process, the ABA letter, is that right?
That is my understanding.
She was the lead reviewer for this, is that correct?
That's my understanding.
She donated to your political opponent in 2014, is that correct?
Yeah, I found that out.
And yet the ABA put her in charge of the review process. Am I right about that?
It appears so to me, Senator.
Yeah, I find that absolutely unbelievable. If you want to talk about bias, if you want to talk about fair procedures, and it probably explains the total ad hominem nature of this disgraceful letter. Let's walk through some of the outrageous allegations that are made here. First of all, I noticed the letter is full of all kinds of frankly, hearsay. I mean, allegations that are not supported with any kind of detail. So I frankly have no idea what they're talking about. But they say things like they interviewed various people. You're accused of not having. First of all, were you told any of the particular people who they interviewed so that you could have some sense of who was accusing you?
No, Senator. When she talked to me, she said she would say, you know, would you be surprised to hear such and such? And I would start to answer, and then she would say, we have to, you know, we don't have much time, and she would want to move on.
The letter says there are reports that your preparation and performance were lacking in some cases. Did they tell you what cases those were?
They did not, Senator.
They say that there are reports that in oral argument you sometimes miss key points. Do you know what oral argument they're talking about?
I do not, Senator.
Neither do I, of course. Neither do any of us. I mean, so there's no way to evaluate anything that is said here. But let me give you an opportunity to respond to some of the more salacious allegations. So the letter says that characterizes you as arrogant and lacking in knowledge of the day-to-day practice of law. I was under the impression that you had been an attorney for 14 or more years and that you've been the Solicitor General of two different states. Am I wrong about that?
That's correct, Senator.
And have you argued before courts of appeal during that time?
I've argued 24 cases before courts of appeals.
Have you briefed cases during that time?
I have, Senator, many.
Any idea how many you may have briefed?
I'm guessing over my career it's been hundreds of cases,
Senator. Are you familiar with the procedures of appellate courts and oral argument?
Very much so, Senator.
The letter also says that you would not commit to being fair to litigants before you, notably members of the LGBTQ community. Can you speak to that? Did you say that you wouldn't be fair to members of the LGBT community?
Senator, that was the part of the letter. I did not say that. I apologize.
It's all right.
I'm sorry. No, I did not say that. I do not believe that. It is a fundamental belief of mine that all people are created in the image of God, and they should all be treated with dignity and respect, Senator.
Can you commit today to this committee that you will treat, if confirmed, that you would treat every litigant who came before you with respect and with dignity?
Absolutely, Senator. I would not have allowed myself to be nominated for this position if I did not think I could do that.
Including members of the LGBT community and any other community that has been historically disadvantaged in this country.
Absolutely, Senator.
Mr. Van Dyke, all I can say about this letter is that I think it is a shameful exercise in political bias. I have no context or ability to evaluate any of the accusations that are made here. And I think it is past time for the White House to stop granting the ABA special access. I would urge the counsel's office not to make nominees available any longer to the ABA for these interviews. I think that should stop, and I will say that I will no longer consider the ABA's recommendation on any nominee for any position for any reason. They are, as Senator Lee said, a special interest group. They should be treated like any other special interest group, and their shameful performance in this letter, I think, seals the deal beyond any question in my mind. I'm sorry that you've had to go through this, Mr. Van Dyke. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.